Okay, welcome back to my new root tutorial. This tutorial is a little bit different from the other ones which I'm having on this channel, because I was asked to especially show how you can install root in Windows. And yeah, so I decided to make a video about that. However, there are different possibilities how to do that. So for example, you can download the source code and then you can compile it with Visual Studio. But there's also the possibility to install it directly inside the Windows Linux subsystem, and this is what I want to show now. So in order to do that, you of course have to first install your Windows subsystem for Linux, and in order to do that, you first go to your settings, and then you go to update and security, and there you should make sure that all relevant updates are installed. Yeah, in my case, everything which is required is installed already, so I will not I don't have to do it anymore. But you have to make sure that this is done, otherwise it will maybe not work. So then in the next step, you can go back to your setup, and I'm sorry that everything is in German, but the English version looks very similar. So now then you have to click on apps, and then in the upper right corner, there's the button program and features, and this you have to open. And then here on the left side, you find a link to Windows features, where you can activate and deactivate certain features. And when you do that, you can actually go to Windows subsystem for Linux, WSL, and you can click on this and press OK. And then after some time, when it downloaded the relevant files, then it should be in principle usable. Okay, after the successful restart, now you can go basically to the Microsoft Store, and we can search here for Ubuntu, since this is the most popular distribution, and there everything works usually out of the box. So we can install here Ubuntu 20.04, which is the long-term system. We can actually download this here. And after that, when the installation is completed, we should be able to open it in a terminal. And in order to do that, we have to click here once more on install, and the download will take a little bit time depending on your internet connection. Okay, when the installation is finished, then actually you can start Ubuntu from your start menu, and then it opens a terminal, and there's still something which has to be installed, and we have to wait a little bit for that, but I think very soon it will be finished. Okay, now we can actually set a username. So let's call it in my case just Mustafa, and a new password, and then you have to retype your password, and if everything works fine, then at the end you get into your shell. So there, once I think we should make an update to see whether all required packages are already installed. Now, as you can see, 71 packages have to be upgraded, so we can write now sudo apt-upgrade. And when we do that, then we have to work until all the packages have been downloaded and also installed. Now, depending on your system, the installation can take a little bit time. So as usual, I will skip this process and then I will come back when the update is finished. After the upgrade is finished, we can go to our CERN root download website, and we can actually go to the releases and check the newest one and the source code. So what we can do is copy paste the link address, go to our Ubuntu machine and write wget, and right click, and then it inserts here the URL, and if we then press enter, it downloads the source code. Okay, and when the download is finished, we can write tar-xzfv as usual and apply this on our file that we downloaded. So actually it's hanging at the moment, so I will try it again. Okay, and now it's unpacking everything into the folder root 62402, which is the version number. And In the meanwhile, we can go back to the browser and check the dependencies that we need in order to install root in Ubuntu. And these are the same ones which I have also explained in my first tutorial. However, I would like to now copy and paste them again to make sure that everything is completed. And I guess it's finished now, so we can copy paste this part and try to install that. Okay, and what we should also install is CMake curses GUI, because this we will need in order to have a GUI for our CMake configuration. And when this is done, we can go now to our root folder and create a new folder inside, build root. And yeah, inside then we can write ccmake dot dot, not cmake. And then we can press C for configure. It will take again a little bit time to configure everything, which is much slower basically than you run it in a standalone Linux system, of course. Okay, now the configuring process is finished and it says that Python 2 or 3 is not installed, so pyroot will not be installed, but I think this is no problem. We can just ignore this warning message. And then we go here in our ccmake GUI. Basically, we can let everything as it is and only have to change our installation path. And this install prefix is shown here. So we will just put it into my home folder and we use the same folder where root is unpacked, but insert an install at the end. So at the end, our binaries will be installed into this folder. And we have to press again C for configure. Yeah, and when this is done, again, the warning message will come, which we can close, and then we can press G for generate. And now it will actually generate our makefile, which we can use to install root. Okay, now the makefile has been generated. So in principle, we only have to write make minus J4. I've never tried this before here, but I think you can actually access more than one core. And then you only have to confirm this with enter, and now the whole compilation and download process will start. And yeah, this will take a long time. Okay, in the meanwhile, when the compilation process is still ongoing, there's one further application which we have to install, and this is called Xming. Now, this is necessary if you want to have connection to the X server in Ubuntu. So in this case, we can write Xming download in Google. And then the first link is usually the correct one. So you come to the SourceForge website from where you can just download an executable, which is basically the installer. So after that, you are ready to install the program. I have done this already, so therefore I don't need to do that. But the important thing is that after downloading and installing it, you have to run it. Yeah. And when you start it, you find that here in the taskbar, you can find this X symbol. And when this is shown there, then it means that everything worked well. And now we only have to wait that our installation process is finishing so we can actually test it. Okay, as you can see, the compilation is finished. So the only thing which we have to do now is to write make install in order to install the binaries into the dedicated installation folder. And this should be in principle very quick. Okay, after a few minutes it's finished. And now we can go to our home folder. And there are only two things which we have to do. And the first thing is sourcing the script thisroot.sh in the same way how we have done it in the first tutorial of the Linux series. So we have to write dot, root install bin, and then inside this bin there is the file thisroot.sh. And when we source that, then in principle we can run it by typing in root, and as you see it works perfectly fine. Only in order to use our graphics output, we have installed Xming already. But we have to write one more thing into the terminal in order to use that, and this is export display equals localhost double dot 0. And this is in order to make sure that now the output is going to Xming. And yeah, if we have done that, we can actually try this again. And in order to check whether everything works, we can just create a new canvas. And hopefully it will show. Yes, perfect. It is showing. And now we can just create some simple histogram. Let's call it hist. Histogram with 100 bins from maybe minus 10 to 10. And yeah, let's fill it. Fill random Gauss. And yeah, the only thing which we have to do is, of course, drawing it. And as you can see here, finally, we have our nice histogram with 5000 entries and the mean value, standard deviation, everything is perfectly calculated. Okay, I hope that you liked the video. If yes, then please hit the like button. Please subscribe if you don't want to miss any further videos from me, and hopefully see you soon.